All right, let's get the show on the road. Welcome to fxbootcamp.com. The live webinar today is sponsored by TradersWay. It's December 31st, 2014, 8 o'clock in the morning, New York time. Looks like people want to talk about oil, dollar yen, pound dollar, anything else? Look at gold maybe? You want to look at S&P 500? What else is going on? Please type in what you're interested into the live room. We'll get that covered. Just a quick update. Pound is strong. Euro is weak. Swiss franc is weak. Japanese yen is moderate. US dollar is moderate. Aussie dollar is moderate. CAD has been quite strong. And Kiwi has been quite weak. Take a quick look at FX Bootcamp. Oh. Come on now. Look at the indices. S&P 500 positive. Dow Jones positive. DAX down 1.4%. FTSE up 0.5%. Mixed bag there in Europe. Gold is down 0.25%. Silver down 1.65%. Oil down 1.63%, below 53 bucks. I think it's going to be a very interesting day today, huh? Well, let's get this party started. Welcome to today's live Forex trading event held at fxbootcamp.com. Today's sponsor is TradersWay, a Forex ECN brokerage that not only offers currency traders low spreads, but the ability to trade things like gold and silver, oil, the Dow, the S&P 500, the FTSE, the DAX, the Nikkei, but also trade binary options on these asset classes and then be able to manage them directly from your MT4 account. I'd like to remind you that today's webinar is for educational purposes only. fxbootcamp.com, the presenter, nor the sponsors are responsible for your trading results. Trading Forex with leverage is very risky and not appropriate for everyone. In today's presentation, you will see generally accepted trading techniques that may have worked in the past. However, good or bad, past performance never predicts future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. All right, let's get this show on the road on fxbootcamp.com. There are five different trading setups. You guys asked for pound dollar. There's a setup there. USD CAD, Euro Yen, Euro USD, even analysis for gold for the day. It's all available for free at fxbootcamp.com. Take a look. We usually post, there's about at least eight to 10 trade ideas every single day. Let's get going. Let's start with Euro USD. Seems like something that's popular for everybody. Back out here. And what do you think on a 15-minute chart? Strong trend? Well, the first thing that I'm looking at here is there's some sort of channel going on, right? Do you notice how we're having difficulty making lower lows? It's not making higher highs, but it's making lower lows, right? That's what an oscillator measures. Did you know that? So your oscillator would be preparing to maybe if start moving up like this. That's what the oscillator is doing. Price's ability to make a lower low or a higher high. So we're kind of stuck here, but I'm not really in the mood for buying. If you were a bull, however, you would take this little wick back here, and you'd probably set that up as a buy. In particular, if the oscillator gets oversold, It's not quite there. Let me zoom in a little bit. Right? It's not quite there. But how would you feel about this currency pair if it started to do something like this and the oscillator rolled over? Let me get rid of MACD. Doop. Okay. So this oscillator, this is stochastics. I have it set at 835. It's sped up faster than the standard settings. That's because I'm measure price action. So what it's looking at is the ability for price, in this case candles, right, to make a lower low. Okay? And once it starts wimping out in a downtrend, then it becomes oversold. And then if price kind of does this, what will happen is the oscillator will actually start heading back up. And that'll tell you a couple of things if you're a bull. One, you're at support. And two, it has been oversold and the downtrend has weakness. So there might be an opportunity to buy it. And you know, as we discussed yesterday, I like to wait for a reversal pattern like a 1-2-3. Now, would I wait on a 15-minute chart? No, I might cut the corner and do a 1-2-3 down here on a 5-minute or a 1-minute chart, if I already had this identified as support. Okay. Going out to an hourly chart on Euro USD, what do you see here? If you're a bear, your job's pretty simple, right? It's made a lower low, break out of a range, retrace back to the scene of a crime to a roll reversal. That's where you would sell as a bear. So if you're a bear, you should already short. You would be concerned that we're not making lower lows. You'd be concerned that the oscillators aren't going anywhere. But your stop is, near break, your stop is, close here or here, or maybe up even here. And, you should just let it do its thing. Okay? You should already be short. You shouldn't be thinking about it now. You should already be short, just based on simple price action. So look at this. You see up here, this previous low. Once you break it, you take this old low, you drag it across, and it should be the future place to short, right? So what happens? Here, it finally makes a low lower than support. So the first thing that you do is you take that support, drag it over into the future, and it should be your future place to short again. Not on the breakout, after the breakout, right? So you get the breakout, fine. Price was way up here. You're already, considering a short. It only takes a day and a half, right? But, you get the short. So now that we've made it a break, lower this, you set it up and you say you're going to sell the retracement. Well, that's why I'm saying up in here, if you're a bear, is the reasonable place to short. Simple price action. Very, very simple price action. Okay? We have like a 7-video training series just on price action alone at fxbootcamp.com for the amazing price of free. So check it out. What about on a daily? Look at my notes to myself. Just in case I fell down and hit my head on something hard and I've lost my memory, at least I have it written down. What's Wayne's trade plan? Oh, yeah. So where are we on the rally now, right? Trading a day chart, check it out. You take this slow. Because we've made a lower low, right? We're down here. Previous low is here. So I drag that out future. So next week, let's say we head up for a while. Good, because I'm going to sell it right there. Around, let's just call it 23. See? It is written. Oh, videos? Right? Hoo-ha! Isn't it nice to have a plan? All right. Hey, move it down here. You can see how many times we've done this. Sell the retracement, great, lower low, right? Sell the retracement, you can see it here. Watch, let me get a pen. Let's do a blue pen, okay. Just like, you know, from this big drop, right? Sell the retracement, good. Lower low, right? Sell retracement, good. Lower low. You could have it here, or this one here. Three-way correction, whatever you want to call that. Same thing. It just keeps doing it over and over again. As soon as you just break support, support becomes resistance. That's why I call it a roll reversal. Nice. Hoo-ha! Yesterday's high. Yesterday's low, right? So how do you trade that, guys? If you're a bear, you want to sell a retracement somewhere between the 382 and 618 Fibonacci retracement. Right? As a swing trader, right? Very, very simple. That's how I do swing trade. Fibonacci, Leonardo Fibonacci. So you kind of need to know the range. And if I'm a bull, I want to buy a retracement somewhere between the 382 and 618 Fibonacci retracement. So therefore, on my charts, I love to arc up the 382 to 618 Fibonacci retracements. The rest is whether the market's going to be bullish or bearish. And that's your alpha. That's for you to decide, right? So a bull, for example, buy in here looking for a higher high. What would a bear do, you say? A bear would, you know, sell here looking for a lower low. And what does an amateur trader do? Get caught in the middle doing both, and they lose both ways, right? Swinging both ways like a broken gate. See, the nice thing about having a trade plan before you pull the trigger is you know when you're wrong and when to walk away. Right? If you were a bull and you bought this retracement, you'd be pretty gosh darn concerned right now. Probably taking a walk. Right? Because it kind of looks like that, doesn't it? If you don't have a plan, you can be all over the place, buying and selling, selling and buying and losing both ways. We got a request for gold. Let's take a look. Okay. What time of day should you be trading gold? We talked about it yesterday. Hint, hint, wink, wink, nudge, nudge. In 5 minutes. Hoo-ha! Actually, that's not quite right. You should have been in right at the start of this webinar. You should have already placed your trade. And in fact, you should have done your analysis about 15 minutes before I started, right? Your planning should be a half hour ago. Your trade, your entry should have been about 15 minutes ago. And the market's about to open in 5 minutes. But doing it now, you're too late. Now you're vulnerable, right? Because like if you had bought down here, you'd already be out. If you sold it up here, you're jamming your stop at break even and you're just letting it fall. But the volume and volatility is about to hit. It's sort of like surfing, right? You need to be kicking and paddling well before the wave. And you don't you don't stand on the back of the wave, you stand on the front of the wave, right? So you got to be just ahead of the momentum. You got to see it coming, you got to start kicking and paddling first, and then you got to stand up on the lip of the wave and drop into the middle, or drop into the front of it, and it carries you. So you got to be in before the money, not after the money. The money's coming in the market now. Okay? At the end of this candle, the market will be open. This is 5 minutes before the market, 10 minutes before the market. Look, this is where I suggested that you'd be in, right? 20 minutes before the open. So if you're a bear, selling it where? At 1,200. Right? Not complicated, right? 1,200 bucks an ounce. So you're using that as resistance. All right. So all you needed to do in this amazing plan, be a bear. If you're a bull, you might have tried the same thing. You might have bought down in here. I'm not suggesting it was a great entry. Maybe you're playing the 55 on the hour. I don't quite see it, or the 200, or maybe you're playing the hour of Stokes. You think this is going up even though commodity market's falling, whatever. If you were a bull, you would have taken your shot, and you probably are getting knocked out, or you're already out. Hey, you win some, you lose some. How much money did you lose? Hardly anything. That's because you had a plan and a bias. See, where most new traders lose money, it's not their technical analysis. It's that they don't have a plan. What do you want to do on gold? I don't know. I'm going to wait for the 5-8 cross. Oh, come on. Put together a plan. What's your bias? Are you a bull or a bear? Oh, I don't know, Wayne. I like to wing it. Come on. Is gold going up or is gold going down? That's where the money is made. Because if you think it's going up, you'll buy at support. Well, where's support? Here? Maybe. With the oscillator? Okay, I get it. That makes sense to me. So you put in a trade. I would rather be above the psych level than below, but that's your call. But the thing is, you know you're wrong. And you can get out with a small loss. Good. Well, if you don't buy it here, buy it at the next level of support. How about buying it at 1189? The weekly central pivot point, monthly M2. Oh, okay. That's a better supplyable opinion. But at least you know what you want to do. And you know, let's say, at least two areas where you'd want to buy. Hey, man, I want to buy it, you know, here at the open, or maybe tomorrow or the next day down here at the pivoter. And you're thinking this. Okay, good. That's a plan. And even if you're wrong, you lose a little bit of money. Not a lot of money, but you had a plan. You know when you're wrong, you get out, take a small loss. Or say it differently, if you're a bear, you're going to sell the break of the psych level, the retracement, and, you know, half an hour to 15 minutes before the open, you're going to sell it at resistance, jam a stop. That's called an event driven strategy based on volume and volatility at the open of gold trading. Is it the only strategy in the world? No, it's one particular strategy, and you should already know when, because the clock is the same. The market opens the same time every single day. You can assume waves are going to show up, waves of new money. Ready to trade at the open of the pit. Just imagine. Just imagine what it's like in a gold trading pit. You hear the bell, right? Ding, 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 ding. Rah! Bye-bye, sell, bye-bye, right? And the pit goes crazy. Well, you want to get in when it's calm. So you know when the pit's open. And you should already know whether you're a bull or a bear. So where's the complexity in this? The complexity is maybe you don't know whether you're a bull or a bear, so you wing it. And what that ends up being is degenerate gambling. Imagine you were on TV being interviewed as an expert, and they said, what do you think about gold? And you're like, you know what, I don't really do my analysis ahead of time. I go with my instinct, my gut feeling. I trade on the seat of my pants. And that's on fire, right? I mean, come on. So
create a trade plan. And this one particular strategy is event-driven based on the open. Well, there's other things, right? You swing trades and all that kind of stuff. This is more of a scalp, but it's also an opportunity to jam your stop and maybe sit on it for a while. Okay? And look, if you're a bear, look at yesterday's opportunity. Look at that. Monthly R1, weekly R1. Do you think that's a coincidence, guys? Monthly R1, monthly resistance, weekly resistance. Hey, there are some bears in the market, right? Then followed by what? A lower high? Okay, you notice the stochastic divergence? So there are bears, and we've gone lower than that high. So retracement back into the cycle level, drop it like it's hot. It's also a weekly pivot, right? All you needed to decide is, I'm a bear. That's it. That's the hard part. If you find trading is hard, it's because you're skipping what should be hard. The decision-making process should be hard. Are you a bull or a bear? You should be able to write it down. You should be able to do market research. You should be able to speak about it intelligently. The trading part should be easy, right? If you're a bear, what do? You sell at resistance. We all know that, right? You're a bull. What do? Do you buy at resistance or do you buy at support? What do you do as a bull, guys? What do they teach kindergarten kids about trading? Right? What would a 5-year-old be taught? Anyone want to gander? If you're a bull, do you buy at resistance or do you buy at support? Do you buy high or do you buy low? You buy at support. Anybody else? Yeah, buy at support. Thank you, Yurik. Thank you, Dan. You buy low, right? We all know this. Right? So if you're having troubles trading, you have troubles trading Forex, feel sorry for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a pip ain't one, right? The issue is not probably trading or your technical analysis. The issue is you don't know if you're a bull or a bear. Because once you've made that decision, it's, you know, relatively straightforward, right? Because now it begs the question, if you're a bull, where's support? That's what you should be doing, not figuring out whether, you know, you should trust this oscillator. How come sometimes the oscillators work and how come sometimes they don't work? Because you're not buying at support. I don't care about the oscillator unless we're at support. I don't care about the oscillator unless we're at resistance. Because I know if there's resistance, a bear is going to want to sell. I know if you're at support and you say, well, Wayne, what kind of support? Well, you know, there's all kinds of things. You can use moving averages. That's one strategy. You can use pivot points. That's another strategy. Right? You can use price action. Right? That's another one. And another one that I like are psychological levels. Right? And even better, you take a confluence of these. Let's say a support pivot point, right? A support pivot point on a weekly basis, support pivot point on a monthly basis, with some price action over here, and then an oscillator kicker. And, you know, if you had 3 or 4 or 5 things setting up as support, maybe it's more believable because more people with various types of strategy also see it as support, and they're also putting down buy orders. And therefore, maybe the likely outcome is more predictable. Right? Okay? I'm telling you, you should be able, while your computer is booting in the morning, you should already say, I'm interested in selling gold. I'm interested in selling Euro USD. I'm interested in buying USD Yen. I wonder if we're at support. I wonder if we're at resistance. It should already be in your mind. Maybe you set up alarms on your MT4 platform. And you go running to your computer. Oh, we're at the psych level. We're at the psych level, right? Running to your computer because you already know what you're going to do versus firing up your charts looking for a trade. Oh, I wonder if I want to buy this. I wonder if I want to sell that, right? All right, let's take a look at our friend USD Yen. Okay, what do you think? Somebody playing this as support? Okay. See, if you want this to go up, look for support. That's it, right? This is USD Yen. You guys tell me right now, do you want USD Yen to go up or do you want USD Yen to go down? Tell me. Dan says down. Peter says up. Daniel C says down. Jim R says down. John says down. All right, good. So here's what you do. For those that said down, let's find some resistance. Right? Let's find our zone. Something's going on there. Something's going on there. Whoa. So let's mark them with permanent marker. Sounds so serious. Okay. Do you agree? Does that look like support? Oops. Come on. Does that look like support to you? Okay. Let's do here. This wick was a big deal. You could take a little lower, right? Okay, so now let's zoom in. That's a 4 hour. Let's zoom in on the 1 hour. Anything else going on here that could be important? Well, I see a weekly central pivot point right here. Okay. I see a weekly reversal pivot right there. Okay, and what about a psychological number? Let's take a look. 120 is about here, which we can see based on price action was a previous level of resistance. It's also about the weekly central. So here you go. If you're a bear, let's do this one in red. A good trade plan would be to sell somewhere up here. Okay, notice that it's probably a 28 Fibonacci retracement. Okay, so I would say that's one zone. Is there a zone in here where you'd be more aggressive? I don't know. That seems good enough. Okay, what about bulls now? Okay, bulls yesterday had a chance at 119. You guys remember doing this live? Might have been in the premium room. And we were talking about them like, are you going to buy it? Are you going to buy it? What's your plan? Are you going to buy it? Are you going to buy it? Are you going to buy it? What's your plan? Yeah. Okay. Came up. Oops. This other area came up into a moving average, I think, on a 15-minute chart. Failure to make a lower low. So I said in the premium room, if it doesn't fall, which it's supposed to if on the first retracement, if it's going to make a lower low, then we're probably going to go back to 50. In fact, you know what? We probably do this on a smaller time frame. And maybe that's resistance. So you got the midpoint psych level, which is about this pivot point, right? Which should have worked yesterday. Okay, but if you're a bull, you can see as we go along, this was, well, the first was aggressive bullish. That one I would have used a binary. Okay, the market's falling fast and furiously, but you're a bull on USD Yen. If that's the mindset, you want to buy it at 119, the huge cycle. The way I would do it is I would have like an order at 119, I'd have an order at 118, I would have an order at 117. I'm ready to go. I'm hot to go, HOTTOGO. Why? I have a fundamental bias for buying USD Yen. See, it's easier when you have a bias set. You're a bull, you buy it. Well, where's support? Well, let's just use psych levels for now. And then if there's a pivot cluster, oh my gosh, there's a pivot cluster, then it's even more believable, right? But it's an aggressive trade, even if you're long-term bull, when the market just collapsed, right? So how do you get into that safely? Well, you reduce your risk by what? Longing the cash market, longing the Forex market at 119. So you're longing the cash. And then what? You short the binary. Right? So if you're wrong, right? If you're wrong on the cash, what happens? So you buy it at 19. It's a bit aggressive, but you want to do it. And it does this. What happens? You take a small loss on the cash, right? You thought up on Forex, but you were wrong, so you lost what? 50 pips, 25 pips, whatever, right? But you won on the binary. The winning doesn't, right? So you lose money. You lose in the cash market. You make money in the derivative market. And the derivative probably, you know, pays you about 40% of the cost of your Forex loss. So it's not everything, but it's cut your risk by 40% on an aggressive entry that has a fundamental bias. But the upside to that is you have unlimited upside. And if it was a carry, you know, if it was a pair with a carry, you also get paid interest, which a binary obviously doesn't pay your interest, right? So it's a great way to get into that type of trade. Now you would jam your stop at break even and let it run. And it starts out like this. Because we're kind of range bound, your trade strategy is based on USDN at least trading the range, 119 psych level, 120 psych level. But your fundamental bias says there's a higher potential for it to eventually break 120 again and go to 125 or 130. And this was a job well done. And you used binary options to reduce your cash risk on entry. A small insurance premium, right? But to be in a trade long term, that's going to pay you 7 days a week in interest. Or at least give you the potential of, you know, think of this. If you were risking, let's say, 50 pips, hedged with a binary option, so the cash of it really means you're risking only about 30 pips on how, you know, the actual dollar amount. So your actual risk is 30 pips but you're going for 1,000 on a position trade because you think we're going to break 120 and go to 130. Or in that case, you know, 129, right? You're risking 30 pips to make 1,000. What's the risk reward ratio in that, right? So, long story short here, guys, if you're bull, you should be buying dips. If you're bear, you should be waiting to sell the rally. And if you don't know which one you are, you're probably losing money as a trader, and let's work together to fix that. This is why I'm drilling at home. It's tough love. I love you, man. Okay, so USD, yen, USD, you notice, let's go back to gold, and then Euro USD is moving, I think you know that. Let's go back to gold and see what's happened. Ooh, chippity-choppity, huh? Okay, so remember, swing trading, what I like to do is I like to look for, it's a 618 Fibonacci retracement for the up. That's a 50% retracement. That's a 382 for the up. So bulls seem to be buying this at the 50% Fibonacci retracement. So if you're up here, if you scalp off of the off the top, your stop is being threatened. But it's okay because, again, I said, if you have a bias, at least what it does is tell you when you're wrong. So if the market does this to you, do you want to stay short? Do you want to stay short if price does that to you? Okay, so now let's say price is up here and it's made a higher high. Do you want to start buying it? See, that's a no-no as well. Why? You got resistance here, yesterday's high, weekly R1, right? A high there and a high there. See, if you wanted to buy it, then you should have been thinking 50% to 618 down here. You got to buy low, guys. Somewhere in here, 50% to 618. That's where you buy. You shouldn't be buying it up here because, and here's the amateur thing to do, right? You were short, lost money. So now, right, you were short here, let's say, lost money. So you said, well, it can't go down. So I guess, right, it didn't go down. So I guess it's going to go up. Isn't that the classic amateur move? Well, I lost on the short. I guess it's going to be an up day. Has anyone tested that theory? Has anyone tried that one? Yeah, Peters, yeah. Look, I've been doing this for 10 years, man. I've been making more. I've made way more mistakes than you, I'm sure. I've gone through every, you know, school of hard knocks lesson that ever been done, right? My gosh. So we know, like, hey, I guess if it's not going to fall, it's going to go up, right? So by the time you enter, what happens? You enter up in here because you're late, right? You're slow as molasses on a cold Georgia morning. So you buy it there, and inevitably it does this, which is also dangerous because it could just be a Fibonacci basement in the bull, right? Like this. So then you short, and then boom, it's up there, and all of a sudden, you've lost on the short, you've lost on the long, and then what? You blame your broker. Because it's not your fault. Just remember, if you're buying on a higher high, you're buying high. We all agreed that, right, that if you're going to sell, you're going to sell high. And if you're going to buy, you're going to buy low. And yet, I think where a lot of people go wrong is They end up buying high and selling low. Go back in your trading and find out when you're not finding success, if that's what you're doing. Like this, have you ever set up a trade plan and you've been waiting hours for it to come together, and then you short it, right? You've waited 12 hours for it to set up, you short it, and within 15 or 20 minutes, you change your mind. You're like, no, I want to be long. And then what does it do? It punishes you. You don't want to be punished. Okay, let's do one more. Give me a currency pair, please. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. Someone asked for oil. I gotta do that. Sorry. Someone asked for oil. Okay. Okay. What direction is oil going today, in your humble opinion, based on your technical analysis? By the way, we're so far down, we're out of weekly pivot points. So what do you do as a currency trader when your intermarket analysis tells you that oil has gone bearish again? Hey, what do you do when you're analyzing your oil charts? This is crude. What do you do? You're a currency trader. What do you do, guys? Canadian dollar, perhaps? But look at this technically, though. Right? Seems like a good range, right? That seems pretty topish. Oops. Seems pretty topish up here, right? You can see it going on, right? You don't have to be a rocket surgeon to understand that. Very supportive in here. And then what? Would you consider that a break? Would you consider that a range break? Yes or no, guys? Come on. Good job. Yes. How do you trade a breakout? Thank you, Glenn. Thank you, John. Thank you, Jim. Thank you, Peter. How do you trade a breakout? Yeah, well said, Glenn. Retracement, roll reversal, down. So, you could say here on the break, somebody's going to lose money on oil prices falling. All right? Who's going to lose me? Who's the loser on this? Okay, you look at that and you say, let's sell some kitty cat. Canadian dollar. Okay, it happened not long ago, right? Okay, not long ago. This is a 3-minute chart. Look what's happened just in the last 3 or 4 hours. USD CAD is going up, which means the value of the Canadian dollar is coming down lockstep with oil collapsing. Pretty amazing, huh? So where, if you were to buy it, you could look for what? Right? Looks like a range, right? fade out. Bit of a fake out, but look at this. Even on a 5-minute chart, I call that a second chance, especially when you're scalping. If you're patient and disciplined to wait, price comes back and gives you a second chance. Okay? If you're patient, you can wait for that. If you're not and you buy it high, then you're going to suffer. See, if you buy it high after the breakout, you're going to get punished in here probably. So you just got to buy it a little lower at the roll reversal. Okay? Notice that this market starts to move right around the gold open, right? Gold and energy markets opening up. So a good time to be trading Canadian dollar, perhaps, right? Neat move, huh? Okay, I'm looking around here. Pound strong, euro weak, Swiss franc weak, yen moderate, USD has gotten a lot stronger, Aussie dollar moderate, CAD was strong and has weakened in the last hour or so, probably because of pit trading of oil, right? Gold and oil open up. Canadian dollar falls. It's not that shocking, is it? So anyways, CAD was strong. Commodity markets open up. Pit trading opens up. Canadian dollar loses value in lockstep with oil. Remember, silver's down 1.5%. Wow. And then Kiwi dollar has lost a ton. You want to take a look at Kiwi dollar? Let's end it there. Could be an opportunity. I see Kiwi dollar at support, but I don't want to sell US dollar. Why? Because I'm a bull. So what are we going to do here? Here, let's open this up first. Kiwi dollar 4-hour. Let's start there just to mark that up. I'm looking at it on one of my other screens. Oops. Okay, there seems to be some, there's two levels down there, right? Almost a full range in there. Let's just mark this one. Well, you know what? On the higher time frame, it looks very bearish, doesn't it? You see the divergence? See, I was looking at it on a smaller time frame on a different chart. That's why it's always good to fractals. You see there's some divergence there as we go up to resistance. Bulls are getting out. It's very interesting. That actually might be a good sell. I was looking at it on a 15-minute chart, I think. It's more of an hourly. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I was thinking it was going to be kind of bullish in here in this 15-minute chart. But you know what? I think the support's farther down, isn't it? So actually, that might be a good sell. Well, what? That's another currency, the Kiwi dollar. I wonder if we're going to have a down day for currencies. Aussie's moderate, but maybe we'll get weaker. CAD was strong, but is now moderate, which means it's losing its value quickly. And Kiwi's already a dog with fleas. Could be a commodity sell-off going into the end of the year. Nice. Well, for $25 a week, you can trade it with me live over at the premium room at fxbootcamp.com. feel free to stop by. And with that, I'd like to thank you for your participation today and your loyalty. It's greatly appreciated. Please open an account at TradersWay. Again, you can trade Forex and some metals and some energies and do binaries and manage the binaries in your MT4 account. Thumbs up. So peace on earth. May the pips be with you. May your profits be above average. Swing by the premium room. $25 a week's not crazy amount of money, is it? I'm going to be over there for a couple more hours trading, and we're going to catch the U.S. Equity market open and listen to the trading pit live. How do you join? Simply go to the webinar and live trading room on fxbootcamp.com. Here's the session that we're going to do that I'm about to move into. And the last $25. That's easy, huh? Guess what? It doesn't automatically renew. So yeah, you're not going to forget about it and find out that you've paid, 27 weeks in a row and you've never logged in. Nope, it doesn't do that. You'll have to renew manually every week. I do that to protect you. Yes, Glenn. Peace on earth. May the pips be with you. May your profits be above average. Thank you to you. Thank you to Traders Way. Happy New Year. See you on the flip side. Cheers.